Yes, welcome back. Well, this is our second live hour. We've done the first one that is now in the ether, as it were. You can watch it back on repeat. What are we talking about over the next 2 hours? Why are we on for 2 hours? Well, this is a two-hour special. John does one of these every single month. Okay, and it's basically a show that we go back to basics and we work our way up to present day. This hour, over the last 2 hours, we've been looking at die cutting. We've gone from the basics to how to work with paper, with your cardstocks, your acetates, your vellums, and we now know all that information. What we are asking you to do, if you have any questions, email them in studio@thecraftstore.com. No question is a silly question. We had one in from Anna. Anna, if you're still watching, we forwarded your email to John. So John will get back to you after the hour. Okay, let him pack down, he's got stuff to do, but he will get back to you at some point over the next few days because we just can't fit your question into the show at the moment because it was about press to impress.
Anyway. Polite, because basically we didn't understand it, so yeah, I need to ask you for more details so I can try and help you, basically. Adam's being polite.
I'm being polite.
I couldn't get it, so...
Yeah, we didn't. Yeah.
John, we'll start a conversation, I promise.
We didn't understand the email, so John will ask you more questions and we'll get your answer questions. Anything we can't do on air, we will go and we'll go out of our way and we'll make sure we go back to you. But email me into the studio. Right, then, you've seen him already. Let's introduce the man himself again. He's going to break everything down and make it easy for us. It is the legendary, the one and only. If you are joining us over from the Create and Craft as well, welcome to the wonderful world of the Craft Store. You'll see this man a lot on your telly. Yes, indeed. It's John Lockwood.
Hello. Hello again.
Hi again. And I love these hours. These are...
I've
learned so much in the last 57 minutes that I didn't even know about a die-cutting machine.
Good. I mean, that's the idea. Genuinely, we wanted these shows to be, you know, we've got things on the counter, we have to do the stock updates, as you know. You know, we have to meet all the legal requirements and everything else. But we really wanted these shows to be a thank you to the customers and say, we've not just sold you all this beautiful stuff and off you go. We wanted to give more and answer your questions and try and help. And I think if one person sat at home and gone, oh, that's right. If I see, you know, somebody else, when someone says on a forum or something, oh, this die didn't work, it wouldn't even cut copy a paper. If I see one person go back and challenge and say, no, because as John says, if it doesn't cut, you've got to cut thicker, then I've succeeded.
That's
what we want to do. So that's hopefully what we can do in this next hour as well.
We are learning so much already. Now, I have another happy hour deal for you. It's already, no pun intended, flying out of the door. I gave you a sneak peek at the end of the last hour. The last one sold out within 10 minutes. Are you ready? I have more stock of this one. Already, 15% of the stock has already gone. These are your butterflies, £9.99, your delicate butterflies that you've got in here. 011088 is your item number. You are going to get the butterfly and the outer edge to cut it out. So you can cut in your card, you can cut out of your card. In your card, out of your card. And all this will make sense as we go across the hour, do not worry. Same for these ones, and then they just cut out of your card that's on there. Absolutely beautiful dies for £9.99 is what you're looking at for this one, but they are already going. Popular, 15% of the stock is already gone, but what do you need to get this? What do you need to use this? You are going to need a die cutting machine. Now, we didn't mention this before because we all forgot. When this sells out, there is no more for about 3 to 6 months. I'm pushing on 6 months because I know how long they take. So once these Kaleidos go, there will be no more for another 3 to 6 months. Minimum of 3 months, I can guarantee that, but between 3 and 6 months. And already 50% of today's stock has already gone. What is the Kaleido, I hear you cry? It's a machine that will grow with you. It's a machine that you can do the basics of your die cuts to then hot foiling. And I think Christine asked this at the top of the last hour. We are going to do it this hour. We've plugged in all the machines. So we are going to show you how to foil with this machine. But if you need a die cutting machine that will do everything, it's all easily portable. The handle does come off. Do not worry about that because that's how you can store it away. This is how it will come to you in your box. It's simply a case of push it back on and you are good to go all over again. I absolutely love the Collider machine for the sheer fact, I keep saying it, it is going to grow with you. Whether you just use it as a hot foiler, whether you use it as a die-cutting machine, it doesn't matter. It will grow. It's going to be one of these things, John, that if you're just starting out today, yeah, you get the heart dies, you get the one-day special. You get the happy hour. It feels like a one-day special show. You get the happy hour. Then you can leave it at that.
Yeah.
But if you want to go on that journey and you want to go a step further, you then plug it in and you start messing around with the hot foils.
Yeah, you do. That's the thing is, it's arguably, and I'm going to say this all the way along. I've tested, as people know, a lot of machines. Yeah. I've been involved in the designs of machines that we've never brought to market because they have failed our tests, or basically my, can I break it in 6 months? If the answer is no, then yeah, it's all right. This to me is the best A5 machine I've ever used. I started out on an A5 machine, and I'm not dissing it. It's a cracking, and it was a brilliant machine. But this is one of the things to me, right? These plates are as old as my machine is. But look, there's no warping.
That is true. I did see that when I was talking about warping, because normally on normal plates you get that big banana bow.
Yes. Sorry, the beeping is it because I've heated it up.
That's fine.
Because it can be hot while you're die cutting and embossing.
Oh, okay.
Ready for your foiling. You don't have to turn it off or down and let, you know, I think Mary asked about the foiling.
Yeah.
So they'll show that. But it doesn't, the plates aren't warped. The plates haven't gone banana plates, and that's what happened on my first one. It's a cracking, as you say, die cutting machine, and I'm going to promote it. I mean, mainly because, you know, I love it. It's what I use myself. We even tested it because the case of this is a commercial case.
Oh.
You can go somewhere else and buy a die-cutting only version of this. But we bought one and tested it against it, and it broke. Because it's not about the case, it's about what's inside. And that's one of the reasons why. But as you said, it will grow with you, mainly because, yes, you've got the foiling on there, you've got the heat foiling. And at the minute, we've got the ink, we've got the magic medium, and we've got the pen, but we have other things coming.
Oh, so it is something.
You know, we're not going to be building up the colours of foils and going, oh, and there's the next 10 colours that are like one shade different than the last lot you bought and all of that. But there's a couple of new bits coming this year later. Hopefully something for Christmas, which again, will extend it even further and you get something amazing on it.
Oh, not even I know.
But
these.
I can't tell you. Don't. No, nobody does. And Sam and Peter are the only ones who know these bits.
Is it Dan? Sandy. Oh, Sandy. Can we use the Sizzix big dies in this machine?
Yes.
Yes, you can. There you go, Sandy.
We even provide inside the kit what you need to do that, because you see, this is what I do. You ask why I buy spare plates.
What are you looking for?
I've lost a 3mm plate already. Yes, Sandy. You use your 2 3mm plates you get in your starter kit in your box. Yeah? And you basically put the big die in between your card and run it through on that, and that will work. Normally I have one in my car or my case, and I haven't. I was gonna smile sweetly at Kirsty and see if she could possibly find me one of the Spellbinders deep dish dies that you had on around Christmas.
Can we do that, Kirst? Is there anyone outside?
Because
one of the big,
I bought
deep,
one.
You know, the big thick dies that's normally in the packaging.
Because you flogged me the one with the feathers. I bought that.
The 7 day savers one they were. Yeah.
If we can get one of those, I can show you. Sorry, I normally have one in my kit and I haven't.
No, that's fine.
But I will be showing you on the Couture Creations show in February.
If you want to go for extra 3mm plates, though, I've got them on the show. So, as John said, you have a plate for your die cutting, you have a plate for your foiling. You may even want a plate that go with your big Sizzix dies and things like that. It was a while ago, Kirst. We've got people now frantically running around the building looking for a big, thick die. Extra plates are now limited stock.
They've only just come back into the country.
Have they?
A week ago. So hopefully, if they go, there are more in the... If Mr. Ross can tell me how many we started with, I might be able to add some more on.
Right then, 12.49 is what you're looking at. 12.49, get them while you can. Get them while you can. £12.49. 494. I'll start that again. I'm just listening to what's going on. 495846 is your item number for your die plates. Hopefully, we'll get some more of them if we can get them. Right then, the machine is very, very busy. 60% of the stock of the machine has now already gone. I can't get no more of these. I've already been told, I've already asked, because I said, we normally do the big bundle. Let me be honest with you, because you might as well, because there's no point going around it. We normally do the big bundle. We're getting to the end of January. I know for me, I haven't got that sort of money to go for the big bundle with all the swanky colour dyes that you've got already there. So, what I asked for was the smaller bundle, the beginner's bundle, the £100 bundle, which then means you can then throw on three flexible payments of £33.33 today. Whether it's for you, you take a payment and you say, well, can I have it for my birthday and also for Christmas? And someone else takes £33.33 and someone else takes the next £33.33. But then it's yours. After that first payment, we'll send it to you. And you have got a brand new die cutting machine with all the plates, with the magnetic plate on the bottom as well. So you're going to get your magnetic plate, you're going to get your 5mm plate, and I'll give you two 3mm plates already thrown in. So you are good to go. We'll give you a foil and we'll also throw in your ink as well. We'll discuss all this as the hour goes on, but if you want your machine, it's worth getting hold of. We've had another good question come in. It's from Anita. Thank you, Anita, for your question. How do you emboss using your Kaleido using a die, not an embossing folder? Good question, Anita. Never thought of this before. Can we emboss with a die?
Of course we can. Let me show you.
Yes, because I'm quite confused.
Yeah. I thought I might be asked about this one. Right, I've always called this quilting.
Oh.
So what I'm going to do, what I'll do first is, I'll use this, it's one of my favourite heart dyes in this set, because what you can do is, if you've got like browns and reds and things, a background you've made, I'll show you actually with this one. It looks like it's a heart made of hearts of autumn leaves. It's just, I love this. It's different every time, but again, it's just cutting in. There's no outside line. Mm-hmm. If I wanted it to cut out, there's the outside line in the set. But if I wanted to say leave it and frame it, which I will show you once I've done this bit, because we've got two sets together, you've got two nesting hearts that keep the dimension to cut a frame, to frame it, which is what I'll do. But to start with, what I'm going to do with here is, so detailed die, middle of the machine, middle of the plates. My machine, as we know, has been used for a good 18 months, two years. And, you know, I will be quite honest, and anybody who says to you, my own personal view, you know, I'll be hung one day. Anybody who says to you, and over time they don't lose tension, it's nonsense.
Okay.
Over time, any mangle, any way, whether it's made of metal or anything else, you know, over time, it's going to lose tension. I noticed with my first machine that after a while, I had to start using the magnetic shim more and more.
Oh.
And then I had to start adding a shim of paper for certain bits, because over time, for some, they do lose a little bit.
Bit of tension.
And I always say, you know, is your machine new or old? It's old, I'll add another shim in. It happens, and I'd hate to sit here and say to you, you know what, I promise you this machine, if you've got it 5 years, you'll get as good a cut in 5 years as you get out in year one. And I can't do that because I can't lie.
Over time,
the more you use things, they do ease up.
Very true.
You know, like my nan used to say to me when she had a twin tub and a mangle. And I can remember she used to get, you know, I used to run a washing through, and she said, right, get me bra, make sure you run it through on the side because I want all the water out. Because there's a big gap in the middle from the sheets.
And the amount of stuff,
you know, it doesn't happen on these, but it's the same principle.
Don't put your bra through them. No. 80% of the machine now has already gone. 80% of the machine, really, really into the machine. Right, let's go back to Anita's question.
Anita, what I've done to start with is I've flicked to get most of the bits out. And you may not have the capability of doing this. You might not have you might not want to be able to do that, what I do. Flick and bits go everywhere and then use your vacuum to sort of get them up, or, you know, have to sweep them up. Or here, you have to be really, really nice to the lovely Kirsty who sweeps them up and has said that one day she will make me sweep up myself.
Well, we mopped the floor this morning as well.
And you did as well, actually, yeah. Honestly, the studio is so spotless. It's amazing. You've time to lean, you've time to clean.
Exactly.
So that's cut through. Yeah, the standard die cut, nice and simple. We've got a beautiful cut on it. You can see there. Yeah, all done.
Okay. Yeah.
But If I wanted to emboss this die, again, using the thing, so this is a bigger die. That won't damage your die.
Okay.
That, downwards, won't damage your die. Might damage your table more, because you've got the lines on it. Yeah, and it won't do anything, because it'll just push the pieces back in. So it's like that. But honestly, if somebody tells you, oh, you shouldn't bang your dies, tell them to mind their own business.
There you go, you heard it.
I've been doing it, you know, in 7 years, eight years. Yeah, you know, it doesn't hurt them. Or I've not. If you've got a really fine one like this, yeah, and you start to go and you get too tough, you could break it. But when you've got a decent, solid one, just use your common sense. It's the one thing I know we've all got. So what I want to do this time is, in this purpley colour, I want to emboss this die, but I don't want...
I don't want to cut it.
So, as we said earlier...
Press record now, Anita. Okay. Press record
so,
now.
Remember what I said about a die pushing in pressure against a hard plate?
Yeah.
And it makes the fibres separate, yeah? If there isn't a hard plate for it to push into, the fibres can't separate. So, this is... Now, with most die-cutting machines, some of them come with a mat. I've got to be honest, some of them come with a really thick mat, which I find actually almost strains your machine. We don't supply one with the Kaleido, and the basic reason is we do... I don't know where I put it earlier. This is the Crafts 2 heat glue mat.
Okay.
We usually have it on end of call or on the website, and it's a slight bit bigger than this. But I think it's like $4.99 or $5.99.
We're having a look now as we speak.
Yeah. But if it isn't, I will have it on for the 4th of February show.
Okay.
I will have it on for 4th of February, I promise. I'll try and put them on earlier if we can. But basically, the cost of us making a special mat for this was more expensive than this costs you to buy at home.
So you might as well buy it, cut it down and use it.
You
that
might as
way.
Well buy it and cut it down, because that's what I did.
There you go, Anita. So you need a rubber mat.
But you need some form of rubber mat or silicone. You might have a silicone mat, you might have something at home. This was designed to put your hot glue on and hot glue gun on.
Okay.
Yeah? But, you know, if we can. So I put that on. Yeah.
We don't think they're on the show at the moment. We don't think they're on the website either, Anita. So come join John back on the 5th. We may have him back on then.
Yeah. I'm really sorry if, you know, we haven't got it, but I do want to show you the technique. And
yeah,
you can always find something, but it needs to be silicone. It doesn't need to be something that's going to cut, yeah? So I've got plate. I've got mat. I've got card and die going down into it. I've got metal plate. Now, if I go with the 3mm plate on top, I don't know if you can... Can you see that's going through too easily?
Yeah.
If I go with the 5mm, because this is what I love about the Kaleido, because it's manual, it'll tell you, look.
Yeah, it's not going
through. I can push and it won't. So I know, from what we've learnt today, if it's not doing what it needs to, what do I need to do, Adam?
You need to go up.
I need to add pressure, then.
You need to add something to it.
So there's another piece of card folded over, so I've added 600 in. Because every die, every card, every bit of rubber shim's different. Now, if we listen...
Here we go.
To me, it sounds like you're walking on broken sugar. You know, it's just beautiful. But this is what you mean.
There you go, Anita Love. There you go. Hey, look at that. Not a single cut there.
So to show you, and on the back... Yeah. But the other thing you're able to do with this is you can then take the white one. Something you want to go through, Adam, for a second, just while I glue secretly while no one's looking.
The Kaleido machine has now technically sold out. There's a lot of you sitting with it in your basket as we speak. If it is in your basket, I would definitely start checking it out now. If any bounce back, whether it be one or two, I will let you know. It work on first come, first served. Give me a call, jump to the website. Keep refreshing the website because you will see it on there. If you get it today, you know next time it will be in, it will be 3 to 6 months' time. So that'll be February, March, April, May, June, July. But between April and July, around then. Basically, we'll all be wearing shorts and short sleeve t-shirts by the time this machine comes back in, let's be fair. So it's worth having a little look. If I was you, if you've got it in your baskets, definitely start checking it out. Right, let's go back.
Excellent. So what I can do is now, look, I can drop this back on to that quilted. This is why I call this quilting, this technique. But can you see? I'm sorry, Tom, I'm making your job so difficult. So that's what happens, yeah, when it's cut and you've actually embossed the die underneath. This is it cut and just plain flat on the back.
Oh, so you really see a difference
you
in that.
You do. You think, oh, is there not? But just how much more tactile that is when it's received.
It's like, it is like quilted, it's like padded.
It is, and that's why I called it quilting. But, of course, there's another trick you can do with this as well. So thank you, Anita, because I had planned to hopefully do this one, so I'm glad you asked it. I don't think I planned it. What I can do is I can see these patterns, so I can cut. You've got a card sample there done in that way, I think, blue heart with blue sections. So here we go, let's do that one. So here we go, hang on, I can show you. That one.
Oh, this one?
Yeah. So I can go around and cut these ones out. So that's how that one's done. So if you notice, it's quilted in the gilded blue, but you've got blue and white quilted separate flowers in them.
Oh, yeah.
And it's done this way. So all I'm doing is cutting on the flat line around the embossed section. Yeah? So I've got that little bit there. So let's just have a look. We'll put a heart down, and then I can see where each piece... Because this is not the easiest of the designs to find. So that fits there. Can you see?
I'm seeing paper piece bits back in.
How much easier is that to paper piece than doing it the traditional way? So where's... You're from there. Oh, so you're that one, aren't you? So I can put that down. Let's get you in the right place. There we go. Because it does just click in. Have you in? You are, and you are in. There we go. In the right place. I am definitely going to have my eyes tested because I've just realised how blurry that is. But that then, there we go. You see that then clicks in. So suddenly I've got three raised hearts fitted in exactly in the same colour. Go over a different colour.
Oh, that's good. So now you can start adapting and changing your dies. Thank you, Anita, for your question. Keep your questions coming in. We're very busy across the board, very busy for everything. Oh, Anita's back in. She said, thank you so much. Mystery solved. There you go. Another mystery, another case ticked off the list. Just a quick reminder of the happy hour, then we get back to John for more demos. Very busy for our butterflies, if you like.
I think we put more of these on than we've ever put on a happy hour, didn't we?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And already a third of the stock has already gone. So if you like this, we've got this big butterfly on the show, but if you like the little butterflies flying in the top, this is how you can create them using your happy hour. The price will go back up at the end of the hour. £9.99, 011088 is your item number for that one. Right then, we go back to demo? Let's go back to demo for some more demos. What are we going to do this time?
Okay, so I answered that one, and I will carry that one on in a minute and actually show you how to do a frame and how they work together and, you know, some of the best sort of tips that people have always liked of what I've done. But one of the things you said earlier and I wanted to show you is, so this is why die cutting is so adaptable, but it's also about what you're doing. You said, because I think I've gone in a completely different direction than I meant to. So this is the double-sided adhesive, yeah? And you said about making stickers, and I thought, if we don't actually show that, then I'm going to get shouted at, aren't I?
Not really, no, but...
Well, you're going to get shouted at.
Yeah. I will, because I said it.
So I'm using here the very, very... I'm not using the smallest. I will go... Shall we use all four? And we'll see.
80%. Yeah? 80% of the double side of the adhesive now has already gone. 66p a sheet is what you're looking at for this one. 15 sheets in total is what you're going to get. And I feel, with this sort of machine, a little goes a long way, because basically you're halving them, aren't you? You only use an A5.
Yeah. You've basically got 30 A5s. Yeah. You know what I mean? This is why it's crazy value, because I know when we do them in A5 pack, we can only do 20 in a pack because we have to pay for them to be cut down. Yeah. You know what I mean? It's a difference. So it's sometimes the smaller something is, the more expensive it is per unit because of the charge of cutting it. So I've put those down. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So they've been taped down with normal tape again onto the grid side.
Yeah.
Not the slimy side. If I try and tape it to the slimy side, it's just going to slide off. Yeah. But I'm going through a carrier sheet because I want to make a sticker. So this isn't onto any card. So I'm going through a carrier sheet, sticky, and then a slimy carrier sheet. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it's a little bit similar to trying to go through acetate or something. Yeah. So I know that I'm going to need a little bit of extra pressure in here. But the other trick is, and this is the other thing I would have shown you if the acetate hadn't have worked, I'm going to put my metal shim there.
Okay.
And this is one of the things you do. When you have an intricate die, don't do it all the time, but when you have a die that seems to not finish, that's too intricate, what you do is you cut onto your metal plate. Yeah?
Okay.
So remember, so what I'm going to do is put my, so I've gone base plate, 5mm, metal shim,
Sticky sheet,
dies, 3mm.
Okay, I'm with you.
I'm just going to pull those down a little bit just so that they're not right at the end. Okay. I'm going to take that one in. Okay. I'm going to go through.
You can hear the crunch.
Yeah. I'm going to pull it back because it's easier to work this way and it gives you two passes. Two passes, more chances of cutting.
Very true.
Again, when they say, oh, I only bring it back. You know, I only pull it backwards
to make it easier for me.
No, they're giving it two chances to cut. You have the same, you know it because you've got the same thing, same option. Can you see there? There's your sticker.
Super fine. You'd never be able to cut this out normally.
I certainly couldn't. I am in envy of those people who can paper cut. Yeah, and do it so amazingly. I really can't. For love nor money, but then I think, well, if I get the dies intricate enough, I don't have
to. You don't need to.
I certainly couldn't do this with a knife or a pair of scissors.
No.
And I was allegedly trained how to use knives at college. I had a whole day on craft knife, on scalpels.
Really?
Yeah. To make sure you are confident enough with a proper
scalpel.
Scalpel to do
Gee.
It. Yeah, it's one of the first things you do. Well, certainly at my college. But you can see there now, so there's our sticker, but it's a double-sided sticker, of course.
I could put glitter on one side.
So, could.
Adhesive sheets now limited stock.
So
let's put
a butterfly.
Sheets.
There we go. So that one's come off first. Let's pop a butterfly on here, shall we? Stick it down. We'll then release the adhesive. There we go.
There
you
go.
So just, I'm actually adding embossing powder because this is the other fab thing. I haven't got my heat gun on because I'm an idiot, obviously. Because I didn't think I'd need it because I wasn't doing any of that. That's just, we've missed a little bit because I've used too strong a brush over it. So that is now embossing powder. Because these sheets are so strong, you can actually heat emboss that and it won't warp and it won't burst and it won't bubble off.
I love these. Love them. Limited stock is what we are for the sheets.
Okay, but yeah, so you can just see there.
Oh my word, a technical sellout. I think that demo just did it. A technical sellout on your double-sided adhesive sheets now. I don't know why I bother reading them out. Was $9.99. It's too late, they've gone.
It's even cut. Can I just show you the smallest one?
Yeah, of course you can. Yeah, let's see.
Just cut, literally. So this is when you're doing something like this. Like I said, right card, good dies. Yeah, good machine.
Mm-hmm.
That will all make a difference. But also knowing the right tricks. So cutting this because it's got that slimy edge into the metal shim. Look, because it's like that, it's not marked the metal shim.
No. With that butterfly.
And you can see I've not got a new one for this show or done anything posh at all. It's
I love this.
The standard one. So again, I can get all of those bits out. I'm not going to because it's boring, but that's how you would cut into those.
It's worth having a little look. We've had some photos in from Elaine. Do you remember Elaine? Elaine said she met John at Newbury 21 show and thought she'd like to, she thought you would like to see the basically the lantern that she's made and decorated with a poinsettia dye and floral foam. This is what she's done from
that
meeting you.
Is beautiful, Elaine. Absolutely gorgeous.
Has she made the lantern?
I think she's decorated it with a poinsettia in the phone.
It looks beautiful.
It is beautiful. Oh,
oh no,
yeah.
There
that
we go,
is
look.
Gorgeous. Beautiful. I am terrible with names. I meet loads of people. And unless I've met you six times, no matter what, in what context, then, you know, bless, I mean, Kirsty's the other floor manager on shift today. I've known him 4 months now. Yeah, haven't got a clue. Have not got a clue. I want to go Matt or Mark.
None of us have, to be honest.
Matt?
Yeah.
Yay! Doug's I'm really bad,
one.
So I'm sorry, Elaine. I am terrible with names. Literally, people I know really, really well and I see every week.
Elaine also says, for those who are sitting on the fence, you can't go wrong with John. He's so friendly and helpful with everything to do with crafts. Just crafts. I know. I love the way Elaine put that. So friendly and helpful, just for crafts.
Just
anything
for craft.
Else you want.
Anything else, I'm terrible.
Nothing.
Yeah.
He won't, don't even bother going to him. But for craft-related issues, you are laughing. It is
so,
worth.
So I shouldn't mention the little private Facebook messenger group, me and my other half, and you and your other half
no,
have,
no,
or anything.
Don't mention
no.
That, no, because no. We're not allowed, we'll all get into trouble for the stuff you put in there. Right, it is true what they say. You are buying into confidence, you're buying into quality, you're going to buy into something that is really going to work. The heart dies, 60% of the stock now has already gone. We've been very busy for these because remember, you have hearts that will cut in within hearts as well. So you've got hearts within hearts, so you could cut that as your outside and you could cut this on the inside as well. As I said, you could do a more heart within a heart should you want to. You just need to manipulate it a little bit, but it will work and it will cut it out. It's worth having a little look. It's worth having a little go. This also works very well. Let me give you details. £24.97, 560, three more numbers. With 848 is the item number. With the big butterfly. Works with the big butterfly time and time again. So that is the die, but this is what you're going to be creating. If you've got those sticky sheets, you can start creating things like this. Using mop-up sheets, using your ribbons and your die cuts, paper piecing them back in and doodling through them. If you've got Lady P's books, you can start doing them. And if you like the butterflies, stay tuned.
Week on Monday, 24.
Week Monday. If you don't know what they are, Paola has put a sneak peek out on the socials that you've got there. They are amazing. I've seen them in real life. Then you can also do cards like this once you are getting that little bit more confidence that's in there. £9.99, 338919 is your item number. That also then works. This show's not just thrown together. With the happy hour as well for this hour. All the dies for £9.99 that you're going to get. 011088 is that item number for this one as well. It's worth having a little look if I was you. Right, then let's go back. Keep your questions coming in. You've got about half an hour. Any questions to do with die cutting, throw them our way. We will see what we can do. Right, and John, what we're up to.
Right, so what I thought I'd do this time is, because I know I'm flipping all over the place, but I'm trying to show you as many techniques or things where people may go wrong, or, you know, to answer the questions. Because we talked about the card that had that really fine detail.
Yes.
This is one of the things, and this is probably I'm not usually a shouty out person, but this is one of the things I love about the ability I get to design my dies with Crafts 2 is because if you look, those two don't nest and can't nest.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, so you couldn't cut those two together, but if you look at them, they do make a design when they're together.
They do. Oh, I like that design.
Yeah, so you can actually see you've got that perfect leaf when they're together. Yeah?
There
you go, put it into place. So this was. A die that just does that to me is useless, but again, you'd look at that and go, what the heck, what am I supposed to do with that, John? So what I'm going to do is, I'll show you a couple of different ways. The first of all, I'm just going to cut it into a piece of card, and I've got pink here. So again, I'm using 240 GSM Crafts 2 pink linen card.
Okay.
So you know what card I'm using. So we know what I'm using. So we know I'm using a good card. So it's base plate, 5mm.
Card die,
my habit of going down, 3mm. Yeah, this is not detailed, this is not complex.
It should cut beautifully. Tony, thank you for your email. We are going to forward that to John as well, because I genuinely haven't got time to go through how a die is made.
Oh, I can explain that.
Oh, can you? What?
Yes.
Oh,
really,
Tony,
really simple.
I thought it was confusing.
No, dies are really simple. They're made in massive, big, long electronic machines.
Yeah.
And they're made basically with what they call acid etching. So the design is printed onto a full sheet. This is why, when you buy a die, you are paying for every square inch of metal that the die comes from, not that's in it.
So you can have
you're paying for the A4 sheet it came out of, or whatever size sheet it is. The design is printed on, goes in the first machine, yeah? And that will be the fine line. And it's dipped in acid and it's etched, apart from where the fine line is. Yeah, mm-hmm. So that gives you then a sheet of metal with a raised fine line. It then gets printed then with the background line, and that then goes into the next machine, and everything's eaten away with acid until it's left out like that.
Yeah.
Like the die is, all connected. Yeah, mm-hmm. And then it comes out and it's washed, then it's coated, and it's like electro-coated. So they put like electrodes on it and they spray powder at it. We have Teflon on all of the Crafts 2 John Next Door dies. Then it comes out, and then a lovely lady sits there, clips them out, because they're all connected with metal, and puts them in the packaging for you.
There you go. I thought it was more confusing than that, Tony, love. There you go.
Dead easy.
There you go.
And someone can say me wrong, but yeah, effectively, that's a very, very shorthand version of how it works. So, go here. You see, as I'm pulling this out, because it's delicate, again, pokey tool, it's not just about that, or using your chisel tip tool, the one you were unsure about, Adam.
Yeah.
Look, it's designed like this, look.
Oh, look.
So if you're, you know, if you're worried about trying to get a piece out or something.
Just give you another
It's another little bit of just pulling it together. There we go. Always do that every now and again. So,
that's beautiful.
And you know what I've not had to use that I use constantly?
What?
I haven't had to take any adhesive or any marks off any of my card with my eraser.
Well, I did think that you said you use it all the time, not use it once.
I am never, ever not using this at home. But again, when I'd finish this, because I never do the finished ones, there's little, I don't think you can even see them.
Yeah, we can see that little mark.
There's little marks. I always go over my card before I finish it. And it's just taken literally everything off, all those little marks and everything off, just makes a difference. But again, I said I use it all the time and I've not had that glue stick. So okay, there, really nice, simple. We've got a really nice simple little heart there.
There you go, Valentine's Day, Mother's Day,
with that going across. But you're supposed to do this the other way around, which I haven't, but we'll live if I use the other one again separately. Mm-hmm. Okay, going to put that on, tape it on. Again, same sandwich, so just die cut, simple.
Well, to get, now, I know the answer to this question, because obviously I use dies, but I'm going to ask the question anyway. Tape-wise, we put the tape on the waist, what the bit that's going to cut out, not onto the card blank itself.
I use, every bit of tape is different. You will not see me using, like, the masking-y type tapes, they're too strong. That's why I always use this particular tape. But batches of this can be stronger.
No, I meant where do you put the tape on your die?
So, for safety's sake, I always put my tape. Can you see it's more onto? Okay, I can see that perfectly.
The bit you're going to throw away.
The more bit, the bit I'm going to throw away. Yeah? So that, because I don't want it to cut the piece I'm using. So if it does tear, it's going to tear this piece. The reason I use this tape is because it rarely does, because I'm actually going to use that one. But yeah, instead of taping it like that, I usually tape it like that.
There you go.
But I find it's easier in the collider because I only have to tape it once because of the magnetic base. Once it's taped, it kind of holds it in shape, in size. If I even tape that there, it will keep it in place because of the magnetic base. So what we've got then is we complete the pattern like this.
Oh, look at that now.
There you go.
Oh, that's nice. Oh!
Yeah, but...
Oh, there's more.
The other idea is, and again, this is about... This is where you have to be careful.
Okay.
So this is where it takes more important. This is the waist piece, yeah? Mm-hmm. This is the waist piece from the other one, but look.
Oh.
If you keep the other piece as you could paper piece it in, Nice. But the third way is to take this one.
You're not.
Yeah.
Yes.
Match point there and there. So to do that, when you're doing something like this, match your point. So I'm getting the point of that heart against the point of that heart and making it even. And tape to your board.
Okay.
Yeah. Don't worry about it having to be on card. Move this now until tape point to point. And again, tape to your board. Don't worry about it. Not going to hurt your plates.
No,
people worry so much about hurting their plates. I've got a feeling with time we may not get to me showing you the basic foiling in this.
Okay, is there anywhere we can find it?
You will find. If you go on to, if you type in John Next Door YouTube,
yep,
it'll take you to my channel. You click on playlists, click Kaleido. There'll be 17 or 20 videos I've done, quick 10-minute ones, and every show we've done on the Kaleido, on the craft store, because you very kindly give us all the tapes of all the shows, and Sam puts them very kindly on YouTube. So if we don't, because I would, but I think, I could be honest, I've let my pen dry.
I think that was from Christine.
Is it Mary?
Christine,
oh, sorry.
Jump to YouTube, type in John Next Door, playlists, Kaleido. It will all be there for you. If you're struggling, email us back in. We will send you the link for you.
But just quickly, if I can show you this,
yeah,
as I release
here.
It out. Sorry.
Look at this.
Come on. Come on, be good. There you go.
Look how fine that is. You would never get a die to do that.
You couldn't. It's not possible. But using your dies cleverly will deliver you things like this. And all I've done is people would look at that and go, that's too complex for me. But that's just doing the dies and using the die cutting. But you see how this bit here is like really delicate?
It really is.
So I might think that's a bit too delicate. Well, game of soldiers, as they say. Let's just cut it off, shall we?
Let's cut it off.
What does it matter?
Well, you wouldn't even know. I love that.
But again, so it's just taking a little bit of time, breathing and going, right, tape it down, keep it secured, it'll do it.
I have no word. It's those little things. It's these little things now where you go, actually, that can do that. Actually, that can do that, is what you're looking at. It's like a puppet lid. I was talking. Really,
I was going to say, you're supposed to be looking at you, whereas I'm playing with my ear. You're talking, and I'm popping my earpiece back in.
No, it's all right, Tuck. Don't you worry. But this is the thing. Right, I've got to give you some updates now, because we are busy, busy, busy. Happy Hour has been incredibly busy. If you like the Happy Hour and you can do things like this, how beautiful is this, using your Happy Hour that you've got there. Or you can make cards that look a little bit like this. Kirsty, I'm going to have to give these because I'm running out of room. So you can run cards that look like this, or cards that look like this. Or, I love one of these.
Penny slider.
Oh,
I still don't know how to make one of those.
I love, which way does it go? A little penny slider card. You can't go wrong. Or you can make cards like this using your Happy Hour. That was Kirsty's arm. You don't see that often. Then you can do cards that look like this or like this. All of these you can do and more by using that Happy Hour that you've got. Loving them. This is your Happy Hour for $9.99. 011088 is your item number for this one. From there, what you're going to get now is we've had another email in.
Ooh.
From our Sheila. I don't think she sent another
email. No, that's our Sheilag.
That's
Sheilag.
Is that the one?
That's the one. That's our Sheilag.
Look at this. Viewers of the nation. Look, oh, my word.
And she's got a new technique on there, which, unfortunately, due to Mr. Postman, we never got this sample in time. But can you see the butterflies that are on the glass jar?
Yeah, look, they've been etched.
Right, they have been cut out using this die set, the solid one, from the double-sided adhesive sheet, glued, put onto the glass, and then rubbed Mica Magic over it. Mica Magic.
Oh.
So it looks like they're etched on, so they're etched in colours. Beautiful technique.
It's a very professional photo as well. She's even got a little name in there
Mike
and everything.
Mike does that, I think. Mike takes the photos, bless him.
Very, very clever. Like that, £9.99, 011088 is your item number. Not for that. That was for... I'm not selling Sheila's work, OK, for £9.99. Something else I've got is the desk vacuum. I can reach it from here. The desk vacuum that you've got. Now, we did have a question about the desk vacuum because you could pick everything at the bit at the bottom and it all stores. So if you pick up all the good stuff, you just seal it off and it's in there. Now, we've had a question in from Gillian asking, can you tell me, does it pick up glitter as it is a nightmare to get rid of on your workplace?
It's a yes and a no, Gillian.
Oh, yes
to be
and
honest.
No, Gillian.
The reason is Adams will not pick up glitter.
Oh, mine won't pick up glitter.
Okay.
I am the glitter king.
Mine will pick up glitter.
What's the difference? Hang on, I've only got one item number here and I haven't got a glitter and no glitter option.
Hopefully, did you get that or do I need to do that? And the problem?
Do it again.
This is embossing powder. This is ultra fine embossing powder. So this is not, you know, your literally, look how fine that is. Okay, turn this on. Yeah. There's my powder.
Why won't mine do that?
Right, and the reason is, when they are brand new, it has a filter here.
Oh yeah?
Okay, it has an air hole here and a filter. And when it's brand new, the filter, it will go travel straight through and it will come out in a big stream out of there.
When you've
used it for a while and the filter starts to clog a little bit, then it picks it all up.
Oh, okay.
So that makes sense, yeah? And it's quite funny because when we first looked at these and we looked at the manufacturer of them, they told them they were glitter vacuums. And I tried and went, it won't pick up glitter. Oh, it will. And they'd never tested them brand new, if that makes sense. So when you see one and it says if it's got any sort of air hole, it lets any air hole, it says glitter. It's not going to do it first time. You basically need it to be a little bit older. Can you see here? Just the little bits coming out onto my board.
Super fine, yeah.
Super fine. But as it gets used to it and does more, less and less will come out. So Adams won't, mine will.
I like that, so use it. What else was at the end of that email? From Pam. Pam says, I have to say I bought this at the end of this of last year and this is now my best friend. It's the best little crafting item I have for 2021, now 2022. it's bigger than I thought, but well worth the money.
Is that
lovely. Me? It's not that big though, Pam. It's only little.
Yeah, but sometimes on TV when you're sat at home, I know, Sasha's nodding away. You sit at home and something can look really, really big, and when you get it home, it's small. But the number of times you look at a product and it looks tiny, it gets home and it looks so much bigger.
Well, this is true. In theory, I'm only 4'6".
You see, and I'm really puts weight on because actually I'm a 28-inch waist and I'm 6'1".
Well, this is the
thing. But the telly just shrinks me and makes me go out.
It's what we do. It's what we do. It's what happens. But no, it's worth having a little go. We're busy for those little vacuums now. Is what we got. Now we've got about. Is that all we've got from 2 hours? We've got 8 minutes left. What do you want to show me in eight minutes? We were meant to do a cars and all sorts.
Yeah, I was going to do a car and I was going to do an edge. And one of the things that I get asked an awful lot, and I will show you as quickly as I possibly can, just bringing random card, is about laying two dies together to do a frame or to do two dies that match.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to use the two hearts in the set because I did say I would make a frame to go on there. So I'll do it even in this fancy paper. So basically what you'd normally do and what I used to do was this. I'd put that one down and I'd tape it down, yeah?
Yeah.
And then you try and get that one and you try and get that in the right place and then you start trying to tape that down and it's nonsense. It's the only time I can honestly say this is a technique I came up with.
Okay.
Because I've been doing it for a lot of years now. It's called the long piece of tape trick, which everyone knows. You must have seen this one.
Possibly.
Take a long piece of tape and tape your two fingers together like a Chinese finger trap.
Yeah.
Yeah? Leaving your thumbs free. Hover over your dies and pick up your first heart.
Yeah.
Using your thumbs to press it on. You can then hover over your second heart till it's even and then pick up your second one.
Oh, I have seen this, yeah.
And then take that and put that onto your card and cut it. Yeah?
Ah, makes sense. Then everything's lined up.
So you're using only one piece of tape. It's a lot easier because usually by the time that you've got to the point where... Usually by the time you've got to the point where the top's right, the bottom's gone off again, so that's easier. But I'm going to... Oh, I love that sound.
It's like frost.
It is. It's
like
just...
a morning walk.
Because, again, this is like UPO paper. Sorry, this is UPO paper.
OK.
With alcohol inks on. So I've used my metal shim.
Give you that bit more weight.
Give me that bit more weight. And I get then...
I love it.
...the perfect frame to go around there.
Look at that, quick and easy card.
I mean, what I would actually do normally is, I'll be honest here, normally I don't like waste, and this is why dies are so good. I will use the middle waste heart.
Oh, to put back in the centre.
Because it's from the same set, so I know that goes round there.
Yeah.
And then, excuse me for speed, I will use...
Look at this.
That heart around the outside. There we go. Try and get
it. If
you've
got the right
place.
Tools for the job, you can do this too.
You can, easily.
This is the thing.
And again, it's with anything. So let's say I want to now, I want to cut out that one with the outside using the same long piece of tape on my fingers. Pick up the die. Yeah, hover over. Don't do it on your magnetic plate like an idiot like I do. But you can see I can hover over till it's happy.
Yeah.
There. Then straight onto your piece. And if I want to cut that more than once, I get a piece of normal sticky tape and I put that tool of those across and it will keep that in place.
And that's what you use.
And then I do that and I can cut that six times and mount it up.
Oh, I love it. And it's these little ideas that take it from... I don't want to use the word boring, but that's what it is. And technically, that's what it is. And you are running it through a die machine. It's not the most gripping part of craft.
It's not. I've always said if I was on, you know, if I went on holiday and I went to, you know, there was like a hypnotist, and they often get you to do, you know, do the movement you do all day at work. I'd be still on stage like that, and no one would work out. I think, oh, you're a majorette or something. You know, yeah, I'm built for one. But you would, because that's what I do. That's not the interesting bit. The interesting bit is what you're doing. But I wanted to show you one more thing with this, if I can, because Adam's about to completely lose it.
I am now having to take over. I thought something else, you see. It's just the way my mind works.
Well, I'm thinking majorette. You know, I did used to be able to do that. I'm sure you can. When you want to save card, you're going to do this. Certainly if you've got an A4 machine, you're going to put your die on in a small piece and then you're going to run the whole piece of card through.
Yes, you are.
That is the silliest thing you can do.
Oh, okay.
Unless you want that aperture, because what happens is, as that's going through your machine, it's a mangle, so there's pressure.
Yeah.
So it gets used to the pressure of that card being in there and it can almost pull. And when it gets to that, it can almost be pulling.
Okay.
You've not given it a crisp... I don't know why, and I know in my head, but I can't seem to explain it why it doesn't. So, what I tend to do is always say, that will cut better than that.
Oh.
Because you're almost putting an even pressure all the way around.
It gets used to it, do you
So, think? Yeah, it does. It's almost... And what you can find as well is, if you've got like a really nice, beautiful textured linen card like this, running excess pieces like that through an A4 machine can press out that pattern. If you've got just a little bit of card stuck on your plate,
you're going to get the imprint.
I promise you, that will always cut better than that will.
Because you're
giving it less pressure and you're asking it, cut it from a smaller thing. I mean, I'm sure, again, moving into the fabric world, you would like to think that you would undo a bolt of fabric and put down the pattern piece you want to cut and cut out from that, but you don't. You tend to take the bolt of fabric, take off the smallest fabric you can, then put your pattern pieces on and cut it. You don't cut it while it's on the bolt. Is that right, Sasha? Sorry.
Sasha's nodding
and
the corner
over there. The final thing is, never be afraid. If you think something's not cut or you think it's not working right, never be afraid to go, hello, 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 and keep running it through. It won't make a difference. And always, very finally, before you take it off or anything, turn it over and see if it's cut.
True.
Because if it isn't, you can whack it back in with a shim and cut
it.
So instead of taking that off and then going, I've got to fit it back on, check first.
And look at that.
And
then you use
done.
Your little dust bunny to pick it all up.
You do.
We are literally minutes away, but we've got a minute and a half left of the end of the show. Jump to the website to see everything out there. My Kaleido has now sold out. They won't be back for a couple of months now, 3 to 6 months before we get the Kaleido back.
That's unless
in.
Uncle Peter finds another box of them in the warehouse. But yeah,
well, we don't think it's going to be. We don't.
Well,
know,
I had to make the call and say, am I all right to have this money on? He said, yeah, I think you're just about.
Right then, so they've gone. We have got the Crass 2 Press to Impress on the shows. We've got the Press to Impress. Oh, they're good as well for £9.99. Your 50 packs that you got in there and your phone packs. Worth having a little look at them. We've got your vacuums and you've got pink and your blue. We've got your glitter card, your ombre glitter card. You've got your glitter cut, you've got your cutters in there as well. We should have been a 3 hour show, I'm not going to lie.
I haven't even started on the demo packs yet that I've got.
Yeah, we've not even got. We were meant to build a card that looks like this, but we didn't get there. But this is what the shows are about. The shows are about your questions.
I will do a version of that card on Craft Cave on Wednesday live.
Where do we find it?
So you just go to Crafting with John Next Door on Crafts 2 group on Facebook. And at Wednesday at 7 o'clock, I'll be live for an hour from my Craft Cave. And I will make a card version of that. Probably just change the colours so you can see it there.
There you go. It's worth having a little look. Thank you, John, for the last 2 hours.
No, thank you. I can't believe it's been 2 hours.
I know. It's gone super, super fast. Super fast and super quick. But don't you go anywhere either. There is so much more to shop for. If you want all the knowledge again, you can watch both of these hours back for the next 60 days, 30 minutes, when we come off air. Right then, there is a full list of what I'm about to tell you for the next 3 hours, because I'm with you. I genuinely don't know what's coming up for the rest of the day. So I will see you in a few hours. So I think I'm back at 7. I will see you then. Whew, here we go.